UV or not UV? That's the question, folks. The sun emits ultraviolet radiation, but most grow lights do not. So today, we're going to take a look at UV, how it affects plants, and how and when to use UV-emitting grow lights safely. First, a quick recap. Bear with me, it'll be really brief, I promise. PAR, or photosynthetically active radiation, is the energy that plants use for growth and bloom. It refers to photons, people, discrete packets of energy traveling at certain wavelengths between 400 to 700 nanometers. It's also the range of visible light energy, the colors that we humans are able to perceive from red through to violet. Now, I mention PAR because it sets the stage for UV. As the name suggests, UV means beyond violet. It's radiant energy below 400 nanometers and above 100 nanometers. Now, let me say a few important things about UV right off the bat. UV is a broad category. It's more helpful to think of UV as UVA, UVB, and you guessed it, UVC. UVA is the most benign part of UV. It has the longest wavelength, 320 to 400 nanometers, and carries the lowest energy. Most of the UV that we receive from the sun falls within this range, accounting for around 6% of the total solar radiation that reaches our planet. UVB has a shorter wavelength than UVA and the narrowest definition of all UV subtypes, spanning just 280 to 320 nanometers, give or take. It forms just 1% of the total solar radiation reaching the Earth. Most is absorbed by the atmosphere, and this is kind of fortunate because UVB packs enough punch, people, to inflict cell damage on living organisms and permanently change their DNA. Oh yeah. Last but certainly not least, there's UVC, ladies and gentlemen, the bad boy of the pack. It's super high energy UV at 100 to 280 nanometers, effectively blocked out by our planet's ozone layer. In terms of the electromagnetic spectrum, we're getting close to X-rays now. Think of it like a death ray. So, as you can see, there's UV and then there's UV. Don't be fooled by unscrupulous LED manufacturers who crow on about their fixtures emitting UV when there's barely anything qualifying at around 380 nanometers. True, UV-emitting LED diodes remain prohibitively expensive and have a really short life. However, whatever grow light technology you're into, it's important to know what sort of UV you're dealing with and take proper precautions. As I already said, UVC is a no-go. But what about UVB and UVA? UVB is also dangerous. It causes cell damage, sunburn, and skin cancer. In fact, the most destructive wavelengths reaching the Earth are between 305 and 310 nanometers, almost in the center of the UVB range. Many plants can actually sense the presence of harmful UV radiation, and some, especially those native to higher altitudes in the tropics and subtropics, have evolved their own biological coping mechanisms, allowing them to colonize areas inhospitable to other species. So what do? Everest, they produce their own sunscreen. No, I'm not even kidding. Simple phenolics and flavonoids, essential oils to you and me, are produced on the surfaces of leaves and stems in response to UVB, which forms a protective layer around the plant. As growers, this is interesting because essential oils improve flavors, aromas, and even the vitamin and medicinal content of some crops. Take this rosemary, for example. These cuttings have been growing under a Gavita LEP plasma on a light rail since they rooted. I'm using the 41.02 grow spectrum lamp, which, as you can see, has a small amount of UVB and larger amounts of UVA, similar to the sun. After 2 months under this bad boy, the leaves are sticky to the touch. The aromas are extremely pungent too. Whereas this rosemary grown under a spectrum lacking in UV is not nearly so sticky or pungent. Now, I'm just using the LEP for veg, but many growers use plasma lights to supplement their HPS during flowering. This is notable because high ratios of PAR to UVB as well as UVA to UVB have been shown to lessen the damage effect of UVB. Conversely, too much UVB without enough UVA and PAR can exaggerate cell damage. Once again, amigos, it all comes down to spectral quality. LEC, or light-emitting ceramic fixtures running Philips CDM lamps, have increased levels of UVA and UVB compared with standard metal halides, old-school HPS, or double-ended HPS. Double-ended metal halide lamps pack a great UV punch, especially high-Kelvin lamps such as this Ultrasun 10,000 Kelvin lamp. The catch, however, is that it must be operated in an enclosed reflector for safety reasons, and the glass panel will filter out the potentially useful UVB. Finally, there's T5 fluorescent technology available too. iHortolox offering their PowerVeg Full Spectrum Plus UV lamps and 2- and 4-foot models, and the Ultrasun offer a 4-foot lamp. Either can be used in regular high-output T5 fluorescent fixtures. Don't forget, if you're working with UV lamps, always wear sunglasses. Your future's so bright, you gotta wear shades and avoid prolonged exposure. I'm sure this video is going to generate more questions than it answers, but that's all good. Deposit them in the comments below. Take care of yourself and your plants, kitties, and stay sunscreen slathered up. This is Everest, leaving your visible spectrum. Goodbye.